Hare Krishna. Once the mind starts believing something is enjoyable, it stops evaluating whether it is actually enjoyable. Our mind works like a programmed device. And once it is programmed in a particular way, then if a particular stimulus comes in, it offers a response according to the previous program. So we all have a certain programming about what gives us pleasure. And according to this program, whenever that object is there, our mind becomes excited and starts chasing after it. And even when it is not there, our mind starts craving for it. So consider, for example, an alcoholic. So initially, the alcoholic drinks once, twice, thrice, maybe because others pressure to drink, maybe they just want to experience something new in life. But they might just get some pleasure over there. And once they get that pleasure, they get hooked to it. And once they get hooked to it, after some time, they get so hooked to drinking, so addicted, that they drink not so much to gain pleasure as to avoid the emptiness of feeling so low. The craving becomes so great that they start drinking not because the drink tastes so good, but because not drinking feels so bad. And actually that object doesn't give much pleasure. And thus, they just go on and on pursuing that object. Now, similarly, when we eat food, sometimes we just believe that some food is enjoyable, and sometimes it may not be cooked well. But still, because we have that idea this particular item is enjoyable, we may keep eating it even when it actually is not enjoyable. So, for us, we all have certain definitions of happiness which our mind has, and most of these definitions are delusions. And we keep succumbing to those delusions because we don't subject the definitions of the mind to evaluation. So the Bhagavad-Gita urges us to not act impulsively, to evaluate whatever the mind proposes carefully. And when we learn to evaluate like this, then we will be able to resist those of the mind's promptings which do not promise us, which do not actually deliver on the promise of pleasure. So Krishna tells us in the Bhagavad-Gita in the 18th chapter, in 38th verse, Vishaya Indriya Sanyoga Vyattadagre Amritopamam Pariname Vishamiva Tatsukham Raja Samsmitam. The pleasure coming from the contact of the senses with the sense objects tastes initially relishable, enjoyable, like nectar, but eventually it becomes poisonous. And when we keep indulging repeatedly, the initial layer of poison keeps becoming thinner and thinner, and the eventual layer of poison becomes thicker and thicker. So to avoid getting captivated and deluded, we need to evaluate our mind's definition of pleasure. And the Bhagavad Gita equips us with the intelligence to put the mind to cross-examination and protect us from being double-crossed by it. Thank you. Hare Krishna.